hope you're doing well. Today I'm going to do a cozy puzzle video. We can enjoy some of these crinkle sounds. There are certain tricks and techniques that make it easier to do, and I've definitely forgotten all of them. I mean, it's been a really long time. So I'm just kind of flipping some of the pieces over to see it should be helpful to do that to spot the patterns and to see what sections go together, things like that. So, like I said, I have not done a puzzle in a very long time. So, it was a bit of a challenge. But that's okay. It took me a while, but, you know, you just enjoy the process and the flow of progression and, you know, watching the scene develop as you go. It's a very satisfying feeling, watching the progression of a puzzle. And I thought I would start with corners, to kind of frame out the puzzle. That usually makes it a little bit easier to put everything together and get the scene started. This video is at speed, as you can tell, because no one wants to sit for ages and watch a real-time puzzle completion video. And like I said, this took ages. I have not done a puzzle in a very long time. And it's funny, there was one particular puzzle that was on the box, and I was like, don't want to do that one because it has a huge section of water and a huge section of trees and sky, and it all just blends together. It's kind of just like a huge swath of orange and red leaves, or orange and gold leaves, and of course that is the puzzle that I picked, the one I didn't know how to do. But that's, we like a challenge. So, like I said, I'm just kind of doing the edges here, framing out some of the corners, so that I can kind of go from there, drawing out all of the pieces. And will grow. There's something nice about having a cup of tea and working on a puzzle, especially in the fall time, because it really makes you slow down and take your time with something. It's difficult to put a puzzle together quickly, or at least it is for me. Or it was for me this time. So it kind of makes you slow down and just enjoy the process of fitting the pieces together, finding exactly the piece that you're looking for to create the full picture. I started on another kind of top edge here, and obviously that's some of the leaf section. The top section was really hard. And I just kind of went from corner to corner. A lot of times, if you get stuck with a puzzle, it's good to kind of just walk away for a few minutes and then come back with fresh eyes, and you'll find the pieces that you're looking for much more easily. For some reason, it can kind of blend together after a while. It's always very satisfying to connect, a nice big piece that you put together and slot it in place. And this was funny, I was putting it together and I was like, this has to be bigger, this is way too many pieces for a puzzle to be this size. And then you'll see in a little bit, I figured out that it is bigger and I had to take the two sides kind of apart from each other, slide them out. And you'll see in a minute, I'm just putting the water pieces together, trying to find the stripey patterns that line up. Because in the water there's a reflection of something, so that does help a little bit figuring out what goes where. And then the shoreline, that's nice and easy to do because it has that pattern to follow along. I was very relieved to find that. A very pretty picture. The final product is very, very pretty. But it's nice to do the, I thought it'd be nice to do the fall themed puzzle right about now. And we're getting there. And you can see I've kind of taken the pieces apart and it is a much larger puzzle than what I had put together. Notching everything together, seeing what goes where. And one thing I found with this puzzle is that sometimes you had pieces that really seemed like they fit, and then found out later that they didn't match up. But and I remember with most puzzles that's not the case. You can kind of immediately tell when something. So we're getting the water section filled out and lining everything up, framing out the bottom of the puzzle. can see the kind of like one piece missing at the bottom. It's funny because you think that like last corner piece or edge piece would be easy to spot. But of course you can't find it. And you're like, well, I'll just come back to it later once I get some other pieces out of the way. So with this, I just kind of, you know, took my time putting it together, did it in stages. I'm the kind of person that does not like to leave projects in the middle, so puzzles can be kind of difficult for me to leave sometimes when they're incomplete, because I want to have it all fixed up now. But it's good to sometimes, you know, make yourself be patient and enjoy the process. So the puzzle's kind of coming along on the lower half, and you can see we have some nice pretty blues in the water with some kind of golden toned reflections. And the shoreline is very gold and orange. Really, really pretty rich colors. And very satisfying. We get to slide that long piece in place and join it up. So now we pretty much have the puzzle framed out. We're getting there. Slowly working our way up. Helpful that if I got stuck with one part or section, I would move on to another one and then come back to the other later with kind of a fresher pair of eyes. So we have a mountain developing now. That kind of helps tell us what's going to be, what the situation is with the water reflection. And the box said that this was a mountain in Japan. It didn't say where. It's beautiful though, really beautiful. We got some of the red autumn leaves going there. And it's working up on another section that hopefully I will find out soon where it blends. Trying to pick up the whole section, it did not work. So I just got a broken point. So we have the mountain reflection completed in the water, and we just have some areas to fill in where the pieces really look pretty much the same. But it's coming along looking good, and like I said, it's really, really pretty scene. That huge mountain with a little village down on the edge of the water with that pretty shoreline in those tones of gold, and then sky and some orange autumnal trees. It looks like mostly maple trees. Very, very pretty. Those are always the best trees in autumn anyway. They turn into such bright reds and oranges and yellows. And then, very helpfully, there was a, I guess probably a plane track in the sky too. So that was a nice kind of pattern to look for to help me line everything up. Because for the most part, the water and leaves didn't have a lot of standout patterns or lines to help me figure out what piece we wear. So we're just getting that taken care of, and it's coming along nicely. Yay, we got the bottom row. And now just filling in those water sections. And it's pretty kind of purpley blue, those pieces there. There's some kind of navy at the bottom, and then a kind of get lighter and lighter purpley kind of blue until it's pretty much just purple. Just around the mountain, and then you get the gold. Very pretty. We have that section all filled up. So now we're going to try and get to work on the leaves that are above the mountain. Yeah. Coming along. Another nice thing about puzzles too is they do have pretty good ASMR sounds. Dragging your fingers across the completed puzzle or the large pieces that are completed. It's really nice. They can do some kind of sticky finger sound. Even just kind of tossing the pieces in your hands. They have really nice sounds too. And I think the whole process of putting a puzzle together is very relaxing and chill. It kind of makes you feel relaxed and chill because you have to take your time. Just trying to match everything up. We're getting there now. Making some good progress. But very pretty scene, for sure. I love that orange against the background of that really deep blue sky. So pretty. Very fun. Big chunk getting slotted in. And then you just have the little pieces just here and there to kind of pop into their spots. And it's getting there, it's so close. I can feel it. There we go, almost there. Almost there. And last piece. We did it. Lovely scene that we've made. We can enjoy with the beautiful mountain with the snow at the top and the sunlight lighting it up and kind of of journey and travel, exploration, and then a beautiful little village at the bottom with all the trees and buildings. And we just kind of, you know, took our time making it, experiencing sounds that the puzzle makes, the nice ASMR sounds, so soothing and relaxing. And it doesn't have to be completed quickly, it doesn't have to be finished right away. You just take your time. It's so pretty here with just these sections to look at. You can kind of focus in on that corner with the orange and the blue and those beautiful maple leaves. Or the shoreline in the middle with the gold below the mountain. And the beautiful reflection of the mountain and the water. It's a very soothing scene for sure. You can almost hear the water, kind of the water sounds as the wind blows across the water. Everything out piece by piece. Taking our time with every step of the process, making sure that everything is right side up and flat. And I hope you enjoyed this video and found it relaxing. And I may do some more puzzle videos sometime soon. But it might be a while. This did take a long time. But we have some other nice autumn scenes to get to if